This is not the MacBook Pro. This is just a moderately specced Windows laptop by MSI from 2017. But can we get Apple's ecosystem features in this? Well, why not?
If you're here for the launcher and all that kind of gimmicky stuff, well, sorry my friend, this video ain't for you. However, if you want some serious features which will help content creators like you and me create, this video is for you. Love them, hate them, but you just can't ignore them. Apple makes its product keeping creatives in mind, whether that be for its features or its design or probably its ecosystem. It just works. Luxury comes with a price beyond my reach. So I started researching on how can I get a similar, if not better experience on my now 4-year-old laptop. And I have found 7 features which will help content creators like you and me create what we make a lot easier and fluid. So without further ado, let's jump right in. Imagine Windows search bar, now send that to abroad. You get Apple's magical spotlight. And when I say magical, I mean it. Whether you can't remember where you have kept your footages from the last night when you were half asleep, or probably you can't find the contracts for your clients, Spotlight has got your back. When it comes to Windows, I have found 2 great alternatives for that. One of them being Yuli, an open source program from GitHub, which has a tons of customization. And secondly, the recently launched Microsoft Power Toys. Both of them are really capable. You can directly do searches in Google from here, find your files, or probably do a quick calculation. For Yuli, just install the app from the link in the description, and for Microsoft Power Toys, install it and go to the Power Toys run and enable it. You can also customize this according to your desire and needs. Okay, we have all clicked and edited pictures of our friends, but when it's time to give them the picture, let me tell you the procedure we follow. Firstly, we will upload the image into a cloud of our choice, then we will email us the link. Then we will open our email from our phone, then we will copy the link from there, and we will copy the link to the WhatsApp or probably any messaging service that you use, then we will send them the image. Trust me, we are all guilty of this procedure. If not email, then you have to find the link from the cloud app on your smartphone. In summary, it takes a lot of time, a time which could have been used to do something more productive. Enter the Clipboard beta. It's an app which resides on your smartphone as well as an extension in your Chrome browser. From now on, the procedure will be like copying the link in your desktop or laptop and directly pasting it in WhatsApp for your friends to enjoy. Talking about phones, finally, my phone died. Let's keep a 2-minute silence for it so that its soul can go to heaven. Yeah, that's good. I'm probably thinking about shifting to Pixel 4a when it launches in India, or probably OnePlus Nord. Still haven't made my mind, but let me be honest, I'm shifting towards Pixel 4a. That camera. The Apple ecosystem always had a very functional screenshot tool, and this feature was recently introduced in Windows 10, but it's a feature worth noting. For example, you're looking for an inspiration for an upcoming short film, but rather than the tedious process of right-click, save, WhatsApp, attach, send, you can simply select the area you want to send and just hit Ctrl V, and voila, it's sent. It's that simple. So you might have a PC which is powered by a potato. It takes half a century to open Photoshop and another century to close it down. But in this mayhem, how can you decide which is the final Photoshop file, like the final Photoshop file that is final? You just hit a space bar and it will show you that. That's the function of quick look, whether that be a PSD file, a PDF, JPEG, or just another video. A space bar and you will know what exactly the file is. This feature is by default given to Mac users, but for us Windows, we can use another free program known as Seer, which can do just that. There are times, specifically for laptop users, when we desire only if our laptop screen was a bit bigger, like probably a dual monitor setup. This feature was recently introduced in the macOS. They are calling it Sidecar. by which you can essentially convert your iPad or iPad Pro into an external display with touchscreen capabilities. This remains true for Windows as well with an app called Duet Air. With this app, you can mirror or extend your display without any noticeable lag. The only catch is that both of the devices have to be in the same Wi-Fi network. Now, before we get into last two tips, I want you guys to comment down below what are the softwares that you knew from this list. Is there anything which you guys would love to add to this list and help the community that we have created? Because as creators, we grow when we grow together. AirDrop. I know a lot of you have been waiting for this feature, and I have tested a lots and lots of apps which claim to be an alternative for AirDrop. Have I found the perfect one yet? Well, not. But I have found nearest to AirDrop, which works reliable and is fast. It's an abandoned project named Ducto R6. I have linked the APK down in the description because you can no longer find the APK in the Play Store. What it does is seamlessly transfer files between your computer and your phone and vice versa. To initiate the transfer, just open the app in both PC and phone and then bam, they show up. Right now, Google is working on their version of AirDrop, which would be known as Nearby Share. Soon enough, we will also have a proprietary sharing solution between Windows and Android. Till then, Ducto R6. Another intuitive feature of the Apple ecosystem is their seamless calling from their devices. With the introduction of the app Your Phone in Windows Store, you can essentially do all those features in your Windows laptop. All you need to do is download the app in your phone and your PC and you're good to go. You can essentially call from your PC while you're taking inputs from a client or just have a chit chat while you're relaxing, so that the only device you have to focus on is your PC. You can dial someone with it, shift calls to your phone, or disconnect the calls. That's it for this video. Comment down below what are the features that you liked most in this video and what are the features in the Windroid system that you would like to see next. All the apps and features that I have mentioned in this video can be found linked in the description. And if you want to know how I make my YouTube videos, you can click this video here and click my face here to subscribe, as that's how I validate myself doing this. And I will see you guys in the next video. Till then, keep creating.